before crossing the road, stop. Look, listen, think.
Yeah, there, and there, and there.
And one more, Beautiful. Okay, Sergeant, that's me finished.
I've got the kids organised and I'm off to work myself. I'll see you later on tonight then, darling.
Just leave the 50 quid on the table.
Listen here, McIntyre, you scab. You're in the frame because we know you did it, right?
I'm saying nothing.
Listen, you slimy toe rag, I'll get you on your own, you...
Listen, Archie, all we want is the truth, me old son. Then we can all go into bed and get some sleep. So why don't you just admit it?
I told you, I'm saying nothing. And anyway, you're wasting your time with a nice and nasty routine.
What do you mean?
Oh, come on. You're the nice one. He's the nasty one. Well, it won't work on me.
Well, it's worth a try. Oh, and, by the way, you were wrong. I'm the nasty one.
Is it like ice in the sun? Is it the cool of the day? Is it like rain on your face? Is it the taste of today? Is it the dream that reminds you of dew on the grass? Or is it the dream that fills you up with gas? Could I call? Did you really think? Could I call? Is it making you sing when you bottom? It's like jelly on spring.
Look, I'm not sure about this one, mate.
Trust me.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Hey, hello there. We've got something very, very special for you tonight, and I tell you, it's going to be a whole lot of fun.
Yeah. Gareth's got this idea. He wants to do a comedy improvisation.
That's right. Or as we call it, improv. Impro. Imp. Im. I. A bit of theatre. Okay, Norman, just get into your performing area, just over here. That's lovely. And relax and shake it all away. Shake it all away. Lovely. Terrific. Okay, right. So what we need, first of all, some suggestions from the audience. Now, it could be people, places, objects, anything like that. So what we want is a bit of rapport going here, a bit of rapport going in this creativity hothouse. Okay. Right, first of all, what I want is the name of a place. It can be absolutely anywhere. Anyway, doesn't matter.
London.
London! London! Okay, right, no. That's a bloody stupid suggestion, actually. What we want is a good place, right, a good place. Right, it could be ordinary, so it could be a room in a house, say, with a wardrobe and a bed in it, something like that.
A bedroom!
Yes, what a great idea! Fantastic idea, though, great. So next, what we want is a person. It could be absolutely anybody, it doesn't matter.
Dustin Hoffman!
Don't be so bloody ridiculous! We want somebody proper for the improv. Look, it could be a comedian.
Kendall.
No, shut up! No, it's a comedian. A bit like Norman here. Somebody with, say, a name like Norman.
Norman!
Yes, what a great idea! Okay, Norman, no, we're gas. This is terrific. Okay, so we've got Norman and we've got a bedroom. Okay, what we need next is an object. It could be absolutely anything. It could be it doesn't really matter. Say, for instance, an inflatable sex doll. It doesn't have to
be inflatable
sex doll! Inflatable sex doll!
Okay, so we've got noise, a bedroom, an inflatable sex doll. Okay.
Improvisation, off you go.
Gareth, what's the matter? Forgotten your words? Bit of an actor's joke there for you. Yeah?
I'm not doing it.
What do you mean? This is improvisation. The possibilities are endless.
Oh, yeah. Me in a bedroom with an inflatable sex doll, yes.
Norman, it doesn't have to be that. It could be you, a bedroom, a sheep and a jacuzzi.
I'll tell you what it is, Gareth. It's my foot, a hobnail boot, and your arse, mate. That's
it. If you're going to be stupid about it, let's just forget the whole thing.
Me stupid? It's your bloody stupid idea in the first place.
Well, if you threw yourself into it, you might be able to do something with the situation if you weren't dead from the neck upwards.
Oh, yeah, that's fine. You come here with your half-baked ideas. You expect me to make something of them, I see.
OK, for the last 15 years, pal, you've been hitchhiking on this spine of comedy.
Oh, you wouldn't even bloody get out of bed in the morning if I didn't put the alarm on for you.
I'm sick and tired of carrying you, you talentless little shit! Oh!
That's improv.
Don't cheer. Flattery will get you nowhere.
Yeah, a bit like a Skoda.
Your mother's okay? Yeah, good. Yeah. Listen, just you have a good time up there, honey, okay? Don't worry about me, I'm fine. The agency woman. Yeah, she arrived this morning. Oh. Oh. Mm. Oh. That meatloaf was delicious.
Mm. So glad you enjoyed it. It's my speciality.
Yeah, I said I've advised him to settle. But, excuse me. Listen, do you have to do this right now?
You eat my meatloaf and then you want me to go, is that it?
So I said to the butcher, call that a sirloin steak. It looks more like stewing steak to me. I don't know, you have to watch butchers all the time these days, or they'll palm you off with anything. I said to Mrs. Johnson, Mrs. Johnson...
Why don't you shut up? Just shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Got you a nice piece of haddock for your supper. Ah!
No! No! No!
Now look at the mess you've made. So careless.
So, Big Jim Townsend, you've been playing rock and roll with your band Death Snake for 20 years now. Tell me, has banging out the heavy metal for so long affected your hearing?
There you go, mate. There's your drink.
Oh, cheers.
Not a bad party, eh?
It's not too bad.
Gareth, can I ask you something? What do you think of the bloke who's directing this show?
He's all right, I suppose.
It's bloody ruining this sketch. He's useless.
Can't be all that useless. He's directed dozens of shows.
Oh, yeah?
By what, for instance? The Benny Hill show? News at 10? Oh, yeah. Bob's Full House.
Not exactly anything to be proud of, is it?
But he's worked with some of the world's great actors.
Oh, yeah? Like who?
Kylie Minogue. Sylvester Stallone. Oliver Reed.
Well, I don't care who he's worked with. I think we should have a word with the producer and tell him we want a new director on the show.
He already knows. Yeah, in fact, he's thinking of offering the job to one of the top directors at Sky Television, but keep it under your hat. Sky Television?
Yeah.
Maybe we should stick with the director we got then, eh?
Watching your eyes. Mm. Will you?
Mm, please.
The Golden Labrador. Unique amongst canine breeds because it has the ability to act as a seeing eye for the visually disabled. A task no animal was capable of. That is, until now. Thanks to modern training techniques here at the Animal Psychology Unit in Barnstead, the world of the visually disabled has become that much more assured since the introduction of the guide cat.
Trained to a very high standard, the guide cat will lead its master along safely, making a wide detour of natural hazards. The guide cat is ever aware that its first duty is the care and safety of its master. The guide cat is also trained to remain poised and calm, whatever the crisis. It even knows where to stop and wait for a number 53 bus. He can also calculate distances and always chooses the most desirable route home. And that busy highways can be a danger to life and limb. Until at last, it guides its thankful master back to the security and comfort of his own home.
Really rubbish game. Bollocks, the crap name in golf.
But Joshua's never been any bother. He's such a wonderful sleeper. He's always been a wonderful sleeper, hasn't he, Stephen?
Mm.
Once we put Joshy to bed, we forget he's there.
Really?
He's an angel.
Mm. It's all a matter of routine, actually. Mm. I mean, Naomi normally gives him his last feed at about 7. And then I pop him over my shoulder and relieve his gastric flatulence, you know.
Stephen, you burp, Joshy, Stephen. Stephen can be so pretentious at times. C'est très embarrassant.
Yes. Anyway. This evening, when I was burping Joshy, he vomited all down my back.
Oh, really?
More cowards, John?
No, thank you, I'm fine.
You will have a drop more white wine, though, won't you?
Thank you, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Stephen! This morning, Joshy pee-peed in his potty, all by himself.
All by himself? It's fantastic. You see, Josh is so clever.
Mm. I took a Polaroid.
Oh. Look! And look what Naomi's written on the bottom.
The bottom.
Joshua pee-peeing on his potty all by himself.
And look, Stephen, I saved Josh's pee-pee to show you.
Josh's first pee-pee all by himself. Look. Usually we have to hold him over the potty for ages until he decides to do it, don't we, darling?
Come on, you two. You're not on one of your diets again, are you, Vicky?
You know, I really do think that potty training is perhaps one of the most important things we ever learn, you know? Joshy isn't totally potty trained yet, is he, darling?
And don't I know it? Would you believe he soils at least 5 disposable nappies a day?
Babies' feces differ from adults' feces.
Stephen, really?
What?
You spilled some of the sauce down your shirt. Oh,
sorry, darling. Stupid on me. Anyway, what was I talking about?
I thought you were talking about how Spurs were going to do this year.
No, I don't think so. I think, actually, I was talking about Josh's feces.
I wonder if we could talk about something else.
What do you mean?
Well, for the entire evening, it's been Josh this, Josh that, Josh the other. I wondered if we could talk about something else.
I see.
How do you think Arsenal will get on this year?
Don't really know. Football's not my thing, actually.
Who's for some homemade chocolate caramel?
Oh, look. It's the same colour as Josh's poo-poo.
Would you like to represent Turkey in the Eurovision Song Contest?
Hi, Noel. Hi, Gareth.
That's clever.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it?
What is it, a rabbit?
No, it's a fox. Here's his little ears and there's his snout there, look. It's good.
That's brilliant, that is.
Yeah.
Who taught you how to do that?
I taught myself, mate, yeah. It's been a bit of a hobby of mine for a long time now, this.
Really?
Yeah.
You must have spent hours practising. You're really very good.
Yeah, thanks. Why don't you have a go, mate?
No, I couldn't do that.
Yeah, you could. Look, I'll teach you. I'll start with the basics for you. I'll teach you the snake. It's very easy. Look, one hand on top of the other. In you go. Look, there's a perfect snake there. Have a go.
You promise you won't laugh?
No, of course not. Go on, have a go.
You're all right, then? Okay.
No, Gareth, it's not quite right for the snake. The snake is one hand on top of the other, like that, and there you go, the perfect snake. Try it again.
Okay, okay, right.
Sorry, mate, you're obviously not listening to me. Let me try and explain it in words of one syllable. One hand on top of the other, left over right, okay? In you go, you can even do the mouth there if you want. Look, perfect snake, have another bash.
Okay, here goes.
Gareth, no, that's not right.
I'm trying my best to do it, Norman. I just can't do it.
Well, look, try it one more time. It's just one hand on top of the other. There you go. You can do the mouth if you want to. Just do the snake.
All right, okay.
That's enough. It's something that means something to me, and you have to come and spoil it.
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I'm
well, sorry. Just sod off and leave me on my own if you don't mind.
Okay.
Calls himself a friend, just because it means something.
Nowadays, you can't be too careful. Listen, here's a warning. Always use a rubber.
Chicken.
But seriously, music nowadays, right? It's all a load of electronic garbage.
That's right. They don't have backing musicians anymore. No. They just employ an electrician, you know. I heard of one band, right? I did a gig and they blacked out the entire southeast of England.
Nobody listens to the words anymore. Not like an art day.
No, not like when we used to listen to Bob Dylan, eh?
Yeah.
What's that favourite Dylan song of yours? I don't write lyrics like that no more. No.
New York City winter is cold.
Billy. Remember, today I'm in hospital. Hospital. It's a place where very ill people go when they're poorly and get a bed straight away. But that's enough of the fairy tales. I've come to visit somebody today. Can you guess who it is? Is it Bertie the Smoking Beagle? Is it Harry the Jaywalking Hedgehog? No! I've come to visit Johnny.
I'm over here, Billy.
Hello, Johnny.
Hello, Billy.
Hello, everyone. How are you today, Johnny?
Oh, I'm in complete agony, Billy. I'm in excruciating pain, thank you very much for asking.
Johnny's had an operation.
I wonder if you can guess what sort of operation... I'll give you some clues.
I know. You've had a nose job.
No, Billy, not a nose job. Here's another clue.
I know. You've had your brains removed.
No, not quite, Billy. I'll give you one more clue. See if you can guess what operation. One skin. Two skin. Three skin.
You know a song about Johnny. One, two, drip on my shoe. Three, four, not anymore.
Just act your age, you stupid